Cool. We're going to do a quick review of Four Winds by Kristin Hannah. I guess it's the Four Winds, technically. This is a historical fiction book, and she also wrote The Nightingale, which we did a review on. And then I also just did two other reviews, Night Road and Distant Shores. So
Yes.
definitely Kristin Hannah fans, in my opinion. Okay, so do you want to do a synopsis? This
So
is a
basically,
spoiler version of Four Winds.
yes. So basically, this girl lives at home with her parents, and they're a little bit like
They're well off.
uppity.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they have lots
Higher
of
class
rules.
at the time.
Yeah, so they have lots of rules. And well, she meets this guy and she accidentally gets knocked up, and then her parents disown her and kick her out. Before that, they also weren't like big fans of her. She could never do anything right. So it was just another thing. So she got kicked out and she went to live with his parents and him, and they eventually get married. And have a baby. And then, so then what happens? So it kind of like skips into then the Dust Bowl starts, and it's basically them trying to survive. And they're wheat farmers, so they're barely making it as it is. And it kind of goes through that hardship. Well, then her son gets sick from the dust. I can't remember what they call this. Silicatitis or something
Not remember.
from, yeah, basically dust pneumonia. So then they've been trying and trying and trying not to leave, and then the doctor's like, you have to leave or he will not make it. So her husband can't take it anymore and he bails, and then she has to take the two kids by herself. Well, he bailed before the boy got sick, but so then she has to take her son and her daughter to California, is where they've decided they're gonna head for West Dust. So it's basically about that journey, and then they basically live as homeless people, even worse off, I would say, than when they were at the farm.
Yeah.
But it kind of goes through the hardships of trying to, make it through the Dust Bowl. And then moving to California, where they're vagrants and basically living by a ditch and in their truck and in like a shanty town.
Yeah. Kind of like Hooverville type of
Yeah.
feels.
Yeah.
So what did you rate it?
I rated it an A minus. I really liked it.
What did you like about it? Because there are
I like.
conflicting things. I put this post on Instagram and people are like, oh, it wasn't as good as The Nightingale. And it has like not, it has really good reviews, and then it has people being like, oh, this is bland. It was kind of boring.
Well, I mean, like, if you're looking for like some hot romance or like fantasy or like action, I mean, it's not really what this book is about. I mean, yeah, the Dust Bowl is not like full of parties and dating. I mean, it's, I don't know. I liked it mostly because it was like you could actually feel like you were seeing how these people were trying to survive. Like,
Yeah.
instead of reading like a history book, you're like, you kind of get a little bit more of a feel of what they were going through a like historical fiction.
I agree. I rated it an A because I would read this again. I felt like it was a great story, but I also learned so much about the Dust Bowl at the same time and like what it was like to live through that. I don't have a ton of negative things to say. It was a hard story to read at times because it was so sad, which you expected when you're picking up a book about the Dust Bowl, honestly. I'm glad there
Yeah.
weren't a ton of animal deaths. There were some as just a red flag or trigger warning to any animal lovers out there, but it wasn't, you weren't like attached to any of the animals. So that was at least a little saving grace. What I really liked about this was two parts stuck out to me. Well, first of all, Elsa's story, the main girl, is super sad. Like, I thought it
Yeah.
was so sad the way her family treated her. But how her character developed and how like brave and like strong a woman she actually was, even though she never felt like she was herself. But then also it was really interesting to see how the Dust Bowl unfolded without really people catching on. Like it was just like, oh, this is a hard like drought, or this is it happened in such a slow progression that they didn't quite, I think, grasp the severity of it. And when the government came in and was like, hey, you guys actually kind of caused this, I can see how farmers at the time, without like a ton of education or Google to just go to, would have been offended. And kind of the backlash they received that then continued the Dust Bowl on. I'm not sure. I'm assuming part of that is true. I'm assuming it happened somewhere, but that was eye-opening to me.
Yeah, that's kind of like if you think about our field, we have contours that hold the topsoil from going down into the creek. So I kind of thought of that when they were talking about like they went to that meeting and they were talking about like how to fix it. And I was like, yeah, that's kind of interesting because you see that in like current farming practices. Our neighbors also have that too, like the, you know, to keep, and they rotate crops. So like, you don't have the same thing over and over, and that helps too. So I thought that was kind of interesting to see how that kind of came about.
Yeah, for sure. Another part of this book that I thought was really eye-opening, I didn't know, was like kind of the viewpoint of Californians at the time. Because right now, very like general, stereotypical, I would say, viewpoint of California is like that they're very liberal, very open, accommodating to foreigners and everyone. But it was interesting for this family to go there and be complete outcast and to be just like treated like dirt and not even human beings with rights. And so I don't know. I'm assuming that's true as well because it's a historical fiction novel. I'm assuming that that happened to someone or at some point in this Dust Bowl era. But it's crazy to me how California has transformed since just like, 60 years ago.
Yeah, it kind of, I mean, like they have the people trying to cross the border now. It kind of reminded me of that. Like,
For sure.
they had so many people from Oklahoma and Texas, and like I couldn't believe how many people were trying to go to California. I kind of wonder if they went the other way too, like they went east. I wonder if they.
Was Iowa affected by the Dust Bowl? I wasn't, I didn't know.
I looked it up and it did not appear that we were in that in the States. We were next to, I think we were the first row, like not affected.
It was like primarily like Oklahoma, Kansas City, or not Kansas City, Kansas, but like that kind of like general area, right?
Yeah, I looked it up when I was like, what states were this? Because they kept referring to different ones. So I looked it up. But yeah, it didn't appear that we were in the Dust Bowl.
Yeah, I learned a ton about the Dust Bowl. Honestly, before I knew like very basic knowledge. I could have probably told you like three hardcore facts. But now after reading this, I feel like I just grasped the situation differently and have a more of a respect, I think, for people who went through that and survived and kept their farms
Yeah.
and continued to like have hope and openness to like try new farming techniques and everything. That would have been so hard.
I feel like when I read it, like if you learn about it in history, it could be easily just a paragraph about, like, hey, this is what happened. These states were involved. This is why. And it just kind of went by. But when you actually like read about it and like have like a family you're following or whatever, I agree. I felt like I learned way more, and then it's going to stick way more than it would have just reading it out of like school.
For sure. Were you so surprised when you started a new chapter and you're like, wait, this is like 2 years down the road? I was like, this is still going on years. It just kept going. It kept going.
Yeah, it was, yeah, and then they get into like striking and the like workers' rights stuff.
Yeah.
But yeah.
I mean, phenomenal story. I liked the ending too.
Yeah.
It was sad, but it was, I know we're doing spoilers, but I won't say the biggest spoiler. But I did like the ending. I think it paralleled, honestly, the Nightingale. I'm
Yeah,
interested to
it was very
read,
similar.
yeah, I'm interested to read more of his her historical fictions and see if that's kind of the common trend.
Yeah. I thought that too. But yeah, I like the ending as well. And then you kind of get to see from the daughter's perspective too. Like, you're there when she's like gets pregnant with her, and then when she's born, and then when she grows up, and then you kind of get her view too towards the end. So that was kind of cool.
Loretta grew on me too. At times I really hated her character. And then her character development was good too. Not as good as Elsa's, in my opinion, but still good. Although one thing I was super surprised about, and this is a huge spoiler, I would say, is that I'm surprised Rafe didn't come back. I thought for sure their paths would cross, but it was just so much more believable and realistic, in my opinion, that they didn't. Because back then you didn't have Google, you didn't have Facebook, you like how would you find someone who just up and left?
I feel like, yeah, he would have had to go back to the farm that they came from. Like, otherwise, like, how would I thought for sure they would like see him walking somewhere at least, or they would have like a confrontation where they would like, I felt like she would like scream at him and tell him to like buzz off, whatever. But
I would have done a lot more than that. Just be a fucking
a
asshole.
lot of inappropriate YouTube things and
True. But overall, fantastic book. I have two more of her historical fictions I'm going to read because I just love them.